What's the deal, everybody? It's your brother Abu Nas, and I'm welcoming you to The Breakfast Chat. Now, this is the first in a long line of, you know what, I'm bullshitting already, I'm lying. Listen, I'm just getting on here, just spitting my feelings while I'm in the kitchen trying to be like Chef Boyardee right now, you know? And I'm calling this Breakfast Chat with Abu Nas because, obviously, I am, you know, putting together, you know, some breakfast. So, I just wanted to spit out a couple of things real quick, especially in lieu of the live stream that I did last night. I want to thank every single person that came out to the live stream last night. We had an absolute blast. And, you know, I'm up here on Twitter trying to be my own hype man because I want more people to see it, to just show you the amount of fun and love and camaraderie that we have as a fandom, you know? And even on things that we may or may not disagree of, it's just the love and respect that's always there, you know, between the family, you know? And I'm grateful for everything that I've been blessed to be on YouTube, to say the things that I say and do what I do, you know? And I wanted to give a special shout out to two people that unfortunately I had missed their super chat, so I'm saying this now, you know, putting it out there. First, Kermit the Log, he had a $5 super chat, and I'd forgotten what he had said behind it. Oh damn, what did he say? It was something, and it was kind of witty, but I'll get back to him. But I wanted to thank you, Kermit, for that $5 super chat. Also to Lori Roberts, who gave me another $5 super chat that I totally missed. And she said, well, that one I remember because she said, pay for cats and sneak into Star Wars. And I said, yeah, we could do that too, but nah, I'm going to stay in with cats. I'll catch whatchamacallit on the bootleg. But I wanted to thank you, my queen, Lori Roberts, for that $5 super chat. And I'm sorry that I missed it, well, for both of you guys, but I'm definitely coming correct right now. All right, on to the topic at hand. While I'm getting ready to cook, I should have kind of like put the little thing in there, you know. Like I said, I'm an amateur cook at best, but. All right, so San Diego Comic-Con is still going on strong, you know. And I made mention that, you know, Avatar, you know, finally Endgame finally passed Avatar, you know, whoop-de-damn-fucking-do. So that one is out the way. They the world's greatest, blase, blah. You already knew my feelings on that with the live stream. So, but right now, you know, in my head, I'm sitting up here like, you know, what else, you know, can happen? You know, I kind of missed the boat. But got up this morning, found out that Natalie Portman, who's our beloved Padme Amidala from the Star Wars saga, Anakin's wife, and Jedi Grandmaster Luke Skywalker and Jedi Master Leia Organa Solo's mommy. So I'm always going to treat that woman with love and respect, period. Now, she just got tapped to be the first female Thor. And they're making the movie about her right away. And it's directed by the dude that did Thor Ragnarok. So you can expect all the usual Marvel stuff that goes with, you know, films like that. But the thing that's putting a lot of people up in arms is the fact that she's a woman. And obviously, you went from male Thor for 10 years, and now all of a sudden you're switching it to a woman. So the narrative now is that everybody's upset. It's the same thing. You went with it with the female, you know, girl that's going to do James Bond and stuff. And like I said, the only issues that I do have with that is the fact that, like I said, you didn't have to go that route. You know, you could make her the same type of secret agent if you want. Oh, all right. Got the thing in the pan. I'm making turkey sausage, you know, delicious cheese, eggs, and some toast. I'm keeping it simple, you know, because I got a lot of things to do today. And I got to reach out to another YouTuber and see if hopefully I'm not too late to get certain things done that I told him I wanted to do for him. What was I saying? Yes. Yeah, so I like I said, the only thing that I really had issue with is that you didn't have to change James Bond, you know, into something else totally, you know? I mean, the same thing could apply to this whole thing with Thor. You really didn't have to do that, but I understand how they're doing it because there is a comic book that has Thor as a female. And they had this comic book out for a little while. So my thing was that, okay, they're going that route to, you know, to fit in line with the comic books that they had out, you know, and they had that out for a little while now. Now, I looked at it and I didn't pay it no mind. But my thing in a nutshell is that, as in terms of the mythology, Thor is a man. His mythology and his story was already laid out from beginning to end, which would be at Ragnarok, when the Norse gods would be destroyed and this, that, whatever, and everything will get reset. So to bring her in, especially in the climate that, you know, we have here with the outrage culture, now people are just up in arms once again. But this is always going to happen, you know? Me, myself, personally, I don't have time to continue making videos and jumping on some bandwagon about being mad over something that, at this point, it shouldn't even be a surprise. Because it is the way that they're going to go. With Disney and Marvel, they're staying woke because they're looking to the future. They're looking to the future, whereas they know that if we're going to have different cultures and different people and different ways of thinking and different, they're going to follow that mold. No matter how much we disagree or hate it, you know? Now, as a black person, like I said, I'm not too hung up on the fact of hating it just to hate it, because, you know, my color wasn't really being represented behind that in the first place. And then the one that is being represented, like I said, you could have put her off to the side because I'm trying to play devil's advocate. You can still have the white James Bond, and you can still have the beautiful black woman playing another secret agent. You know, y'all can have the best of both worlds. You could have done that with the whole Thor thing. You know, you didn't have to call her Thor. Call her Beta Ray Bill. Shit, she got Beta Ray Bill was an alien. And he got a hammer made for him by the Norse gods and stuff. And then he went off in his adventure. You could have had the woman do the same thing too. You didn't have to call her Thor. But since you did, and since you went with the comic route, okay, it is what it is. You know? But I'm trying to give my subscribers a different perspective, knowing that this outrage culture is going to keep doing what they're doing. And the more that we scream and bitch and moan and yeah, we're upset. You know, more about our white brothers and sisters is more upset with it. You know, because it just seems like the outrage and the identity politics is running amok, which it is. And Odin was on point with that. But since we can't change it other than our pockets, and that should be the telling thing. That's why I always said when I boycott episode 9, I'm trying to prove a point. I'm proving a point that my dollars and, you know, the things that I work hard for, that I spend my money on, and the things that I want to be entertained, I want you to entertain it in a way that I feel like my money is well spent. You understand what I'm saying? So that's how I feel in a nutshell. If you're not doing anything to give us a little fan service. I know you want to tell your stories and stuff like that, but okay. But tell it in a way that you don't disrespect, you know, established lore and things that I'm used to seeing. And if you want to go the different route, then create all new characters for that. And even then, if it's compelling, I'll follow it, you know? Good characters and great story structure doesn't have color, you know? So you can, yes, you can mix it up and mix it up good. But certain things that's already established, like I said, you don't have to necessarily, you know, shit on it, just like they did with Captain Marvel, because Captain Marvel was a dude, you know, but then he died, then the female Miss Marvel came in, and she was Miss Marvel up until Rogue took her powers, and then the black woman became Captain Marvel, and she was Captain Marvel for damn near 10 years. Y'all didn't even gave a thought about her. So if it's all about the diversity and all of that other good shit, you would have chose Monica Rambeau to stay as Captain Marvel because she was Captain Marvel doing a lot of the heydays of the 80s and the 90s. And people still remember that. So for a black man like myself, I don't co-sign to the white Captain Marvel because I already know the history behind it. More identity politics. But I'm done with that. You know? I'm done. My thing is to shut shit down that I feel appalling to me as a consumer, you know? But being that I'm black, I have somewhat of a difference of opinion, but I can understand my white brothers and sisters when they are looking at something and they just feel like, you know, their culture is just being, you know, just changed around just to fit a narrative. That you can easily still have the narrative, say what you want to say, and make something up. It's almost like people are scared to make something new because you gotta make something new at some point. And, you know, sometimes Oh, shoot. I don't want to burn down my damn house. Whoa, daddy. What, daddy? Okay. So, you know, you want to be able to make something new without having to shit on the old. You know, because some old, the stuff that we have in terms of entertainment, comic books, movies and stuff, it's timeless, man. It's timeless. And I'm definitely speaking about the Star Wars saga under George Lucas. But this is my perspective on the whole thing. The whole Thor girl is from a comic. They're going to roll with the comic version and they're making a movie about it. You know, Natalie Portman is that girl. I love that woman to death. Okay? I'm not pleased that she's taking on the role to be the female Thor, even though it's in the comic, but I understand where Marvel is going. So, outside of my little gripes about Thor being a man and his mythology was that, so you don't really necessarily have to change it. But since you did, because you already got a comic out, you had that out for a while, I see where you're going. And that's the future of Marvel. So if you really are not digging it, you better boycott it and move on. Because keep spitting out that you're angry and upset, it's not going to change what they're doing. It really isn't. Unless you're boycotting it and they lose money. And that's the only way they're going to feel it. But as it stands, like I said, oh, let me turn this on. Woo! I'm not cooking breakfast, boy, but he's ready to burn down the house. But, well, I like the fact that, to switch gears a little bit, that they rebooting Blade, but they brought Mahershala Ali. Yeah, I can't even pronounce his first name correctly, but you know who I'm talking about. You know, he's a great actor. You know, I actually peeped out Moonlight. You know, some of the things I wasn't digging, but on the whole, the movie was aight. But his acting abilities was top-notch. He was in House of Cards. He was in Luke Cage. And he rocked the shit out of that with Luke Cage. You know? And choosing him as Blade, that's a smart move by Marvel. I gotta give it to him. I mean, the jury for me is still out until I see the trailer. You know what I'm saying? I want to see what direction they think they're going to take them. If they stay true to the comics and, you know, and the stuff that I'm used to seeing about Blade that I fuck with. You know, but other than that, know me. Wesley Snipes all day, every day. That's still my Blade. You know, Guillermo del Toro, you know, directing. That's still my Blade. But yeah, other than that, ladies and gentlemen, you know, let's try to, you know, stay even keel with our thoughts and feelings on this whole woke culture that's just kicking it into overdrive. Because there's always going to be something else that they're going to come up with that's going to be, like I said, making people angry. And got to try to start putting things in perspective now and just, like I said, and just hold the fort down, boycott, or just, like, let it go, you know? Because nothing is shocking at this point. So thank you all for hanging out with Abu Nas, you know, breakfast in the morning as I'm, you know, still cooking, but I'm trying to hold this thing while I'm doing it, you know. But know that you guys, you know, are my family. I love y'all to death. I'm so glad and I'm so humbled to be part of the Phantom Menace. And I hope that you all have a wonderful day. Stay good to yourself and be good to others. Check you later.